Welcome. We'll talk about the various names and the types of the moons in this lecture, and that talks about supermoon, blue moon, black moon, and so on. So let's first talk about supermoon. Now, supermoon is a position where the moon is closest to the Earth. Now, how does it happen? The moon revolves around Earth. At a point where it is closest is what is known as perigee. And at the point where it is farthest is known as apogee. So this is the point where the moon comes closest to the Earth, and this is what is known as supermoon because it appears very giant in size. And this term was given by Richard Noel back in 1979. So a very, very important term and a definition. The next is red moon, which is also known as blood moon. Now, when we talk about red moon or blood moon, it is basically a total lunar eclipse. Now, what would happen in a total lunar eclipse? Earth comes in between sun and moon. So you have Earth lying in between sun and moon. As a result, the light is blocked. And since the light is blocked on the moon, you have indirect light that is seen. And this indirect light turns moon red in color. And therefore, it is known as red moon or blood moon. The next interesting one is blue moon. Now, blue moon is a second full moon in a calendar month. So every 2.5 years nearly, this blue moon comes. It does not appear blue in color. So forget about it. That's very, very important. The name is derived from Bevel moon. Bevel means betrayal. So it is betraying the normal cycle. Usually in 1 month you have just one full moon, but this is a second full moon seen in a month, and therefore it is betraying the normal pattern and known as a Bellum moon, which is also later on called as the blue moon. Now, just reverse of this blue moon is what is black moon. So this is second full moon in a calendar month. However, black moon is a second new moon in a calendar month. Usually you just have one new moon, but in certain cases you have a second new moon. Off and on, we say every 32 months this phenomena is seen. In the Western Hemisphere, generally it's the 31st July where you have an extra second new moon that is seen. So this is inverse or a flip of what we can say the blue moon is what is black moon. The next is harvest moon. Very, very important. This harvest moon is a bright moon which occurs very closer to the beginning of autumn. Now, what happens during the time where there was no electricity? Farmers in agricultural land used to depend solely on the light of the moon for harvesting the crops late into the night time, and this is very, very important during the fall season specifically, and therefore it is known as harvest moon. The next important is a full wolf moon. It is also known by different names as old moon, moon after Yule, or snow moon. It is the first full moon that is visible in the month of January. And usually in the primitive times, it was believed that wolves would howl outside the villages during a full wolf moon. And that's one of the popular sayings that is believed. So the other name of the full wolf moon, which is old moon, snow moon, and moon after Yule, is very, very important. So those are different types of moon. Every year we witness some of those, and in this year particularly you had a lot of those that were heard. So very, very important from your exam perspective and your general knowledge as well. We'll be coming up with many more interesting lessons. Stay subscribed. Have a wonderful day ahead.